नमस्ते, आई एम कृष्ण मिश्रा फ्रॉम इंडिया मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट। आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग वेदर रिव्यू ड्यूरिंग पास्ट वन वीक एंड वेदर फोरकास्ट फॉर अपकमिंग टू वीक्स। सो ड्यूरिंग लास्ट वन वीक आवर मेजर वेदर फीचर वॉज हैवी टू वेरी हैवी विद एक्सट्रीमली हैवी रेनफॉल ओवर तमिलनाडु एंड फ्रॉम 10th ऑनवर्ड्स वी हैव बीन विटनेसिंग सीवियर कोल्ड वेव टू सीवियर कोल्ड वेव कंडीशंस ओवर प्लेन्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया। सो वी विल बिगिन। सो वी हैड थ्री मेजर सिस्टम्स। फर्स्ट वन वॉज WD ओवर नॉर्थ पाकिस्तान एंड नेबरहुड विच मूव्ड ईस्ट वर्ड्स एंड बिकेम लेस मार्क्ड ऑन 12th ऑफ जनवरी। ऑल्दो इट्स ड्यू टू एब्सेंस ऑफ एनी लो लेवल सपोर्ट, दिस WD कुड कॉज ओनली आइसोलेटेड टू स्कैटर्ड रेनफॉल ओवर द हिल्स एंड एडजॉइनिंग जस्ट नॉर्थ पंजाब एंड नॉर्थ हरियाणा ओनली। देन वी हैड दिस साइक्लोनिक सर्कुलेशन ओवर इक्वेटोरियल इंडियन ओशन एंड एडजॉइनिंग सेंट्रल पार्ट ऑफ साउथ बे ऑफ बंगाल विच मूव्ड वेस्टवर्ड्स अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ ईस्टर्ली वेव एंड इट कॉज्ड फेयरली वाइड स्प्रेड रेनफॉल ओवर तमिलनाडु, केरला एंड साउथ कर्नाटक, रायलसीमा एंड सदर्न पार्ट ऑफ कोस्टल आंध्र प्रदेश, एंड आउट ऑफ विच ड्यूरिंग 11th to 14th इवन वेरी हैवी रेनफॉल वॉज ऑब्जर्व ओवर तमिलनाडु एंड ऑन 13th एक्सट्रीमली हैवी रेनफॉल वॉज ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व ओवर तमिलनाडु। वी हैड अनदर सिस्टम ओवर लक्षद्वीप एरिया एंड देर एक्सटेंडेड ट्रफ एट लोअर लेवल्स एट 0.9 किलोमीटर अप टू साउथ गुजरात रीजन विच बाय द कोर्स ऑफ टाइम वेंट अप टू नॉर्थ वेस्ट MP एंड देन ऑन 10th ऑफ जनवरी इट वॉज अप टू नॉर्थ महाराष्ट्र। सो अंडर द इन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ दिस ट्रफ एंड दीज ईस्टर्ली वेव्स वी हैड एक्सपीरियंस्ड ड्यूरिंग 8th to 10th ऑफ जनवरी scattered to fairly widespread rainfall over this region starting from Gujarat and coming up to our Karnataka and southern parts of Andhra Pradesh. So these are the satellite animations for past 1 week and this is observed rainfall animation for past 1 week and we can see that over on 11th of January rainfall over Bhuvanagiri was 11 centimeter over Tamil Nadu. On 12th January it was 18 centimeter. On 13th of January it was 28 centimeter, which comes under extremely heavy rainfall category, and two other stations reported. So total 17 stations reported heavy to very heavy and isolated extremely heavy rainfall over Tamil Nadu on 13th of January. And 14th January also one station has reported Tirunel Valley 18 centimeter over Tamil Nadu. So as we have discussed, isolated rainfall occurred over our western Himalayan region and isolated to scattered over west MP and Maharashtra and scattered to fairly widespread over Karnataka. So this is our weekly rainfall, realized rainfall, and this is our seasonal realized rainfall, and the season starts from 1st of January and ends at 13th of January. So we can see that the weekly departure is highest over southern peninsula, that is 864%, which is around 9 times the normal. And as a season as a whole, we also can see that the northwest India is showing 140% of departure, that is around 1.5 times of normal rainfall, and southern peninsula is showing around 7 times rainfall than the normal. And we can see the color for in the weekly map, we can see that due to this trough in lower level and due to this active easterly wave, we can see that over Gujarat, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, more than above normal rainfall has been observed. And in this monthly map, we can see that the above normal rainfall is over western Himalayan region and the plains of northwest India, and that one was due to active western disturbance in the first week of जनवरी। एंड आफ्टर द पासेज ऑफ दिस दैट एक्टिव वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंस बाय 6th ऑफ जनवरी अगेन द विंड्स कोल्ड ड्राई नॉर्थ वेस्टर्ली विंड्स सेटल्ड ओवर प्लेन्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया एंड कोल्ड वेव कंडीशंस एंड कोल्ड डे कंडीशंस स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 11th जनवरी एंड दे आर नाउ प्रिवेलिंग ओवर द प्लेन्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया एंड ऑल्सो सब्सिक्वेंटली देर वॉज ऑल्सो डेंस टू वेरी डेंस फॉग ओवर द प्लेन्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया पंजाब हरियाणा नॉर्थ राजस्थान नॉर्थ एमपी एंड उत्तर प्रदेश। वी कैन सी द सिनॉप्टिक सिस्टम्स एज ऑफ टुडे एंड देर इज नो सिग्निफिकेंट सिनॉप्टिक सिस्टम। वी हैड वन सर्कुलेशन वी हैड ओवर हियर ओवर इक्वेटोरियल इंडियन ओशन विच केम ओवर दिस Comorin adjoining Maldives area and then this has come over Southeast Arabian Sea and this circulation is there but this has become insignificant for Indian region. So next 5 days we can see as in this map that cold wave to severe cold wave conditions are going to prevail over plains of Northwest India, Punjab, Haryana, UP, Bihar, North Rajasthan and North MP. So they are going to continue for next 3-4 days. After that there will be slight respite from this which we will see in the forecast summary coming. So this is next 1 week 850 HPA wind animation but we will focus on 925 HPA wind animation which is major contributing wind in the cold wave conditions. So 925 HPA wind. So this is our 925 HPA wind and we can see that northwesterly winds are prevailing over plains of northwest India and due to cold and dry these winds are cold and dry so cold wave conditions are going to persist up to 17th of December. From 18th December we can see that easterly winds are settling over these plains. So for a brief period for 18th to 20th there will be slight respite in cold wave conditions and again cold wave conditions will settle over this region. So this is our model guidance taken from extended range forecast for rainfall and the next one is for minimum temperature and next one is for maximum temperature. These model guidance we actually take help of these model guidance in preparing our final in disseminating our final forecast to the general public. And this is our forecast for cyclogenesis. So we can see that there is no this low, moderate or high probability area shown over these two basins, Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea in the week 1 or in the week 2. So there is no cyclogenesis probability during upcoming 2 weeks. So now here is the forecast summary. So as we have discussed, so first of all let us come over to the southern peninsula where we recently experienced heavy to very heavy and extremely heavy spell during 11th to 14th of January. So now due to southward shifting of easterly winds over the Bay of Bengal, the northeast monsoon over southern peninsula is very likely to withdraw around 20th of January. Next week when we come over to the plains of northwest India, so as we have seen earlier, so the cold wave, cold day and dense to very dense fog conditions will continue up to 19th of January and from 20th of January there will be a slight 18th of January there will be a slight rise in temperature and we will have slight relief from cold wave but again the cold wave spell will start from 20th January and it will continue for next 3-4 days and after that we are in the outlook period that is in the week 2 period we are experiencing little respite from the cold wave condition. So in the week 2 we can see in the week 2 there is neither there is an active western disturbance nor there is north east monsoon is very likely to withdraw in the week one itself. So in the week two, we can only conclude that there, due to absence of any active western disturbance and due to absence of any strong easterly incursion over the plains of northwest India, temperatures over plains of northwest India are likely to remain below normal by 2 to 3 degree, and a cold wave spell of lesser severity is very likely during the week 2 over the plains. India Meteorological Department is available on every possible platform. Our website mausam.imd.gov.in. We are available on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube. We also run a blog whose link can be seen over our website mausam.imd.gov.in. And we have also launched recently 3 apps, one for location specific forecast and warning, that is Mausam app. Second one is for agro advisory services, that is Meghdoot app. And third one is Damini app for lightning alert. So except this, India Meteorological Department has recently taken a new initiative of crowdsourcing. So as we can see that we can go over to the mausam.imd.gov.in website, and there we have a link of public observation. So this is our website mausam.imd.gov.in, and here is the link of public observation. And by going over this link, anybody in any corner of the country can go over to his state, district and date of the weather event he has observed, and can put that weather event into this, choose from here the hours of the weather observed, kind of weather, and any other explanations, any other specifications about the weather. And he can also upload any picture regarding the weather and can submit, and that will be submitted finally to India Meteorological Department. So this is the new initiative of crowdsourcing, and we request you to participate in this initiative. Now today is 15th January and it is 146th Foundation Day of India Meteorological Department. Director General Meteorology of India Meteorological Department invites you all to participate in this foundation festival through this webcast video link over this webcast.gov.in/moes/imd/. And this link we have also given on our Facebook page. You can also see it there, and anybody can participate in this link. Dr. Harshvardhan, Honorable Minister of Ministry of Earth Sciences, will be our chief guest, and Chief Ministers of Uttarakhand and Himachal Pradesh, Honorable Trivendra Singh Rawat and Honorable Jairam Thakur, shall be guest of honor. Secretary, Ministry of Earth Sciences, Dr. Madhavan Nair, will be presiding over this function. So you all are requested to participate in this Foundation Day festival through our this webcast video link, which you can find over our Facebook page, our website, and everywhere it is available. Thank you very much.